test and a setup analysis that we're going to do today. He's about to hit his 12th shot at the target up here at the green, and we're running competition to see if you can guess where the majority of the 12 shots have gone by looking at his setup. Righto, Keith, set it up and whack it at the target for me. Don't get that one on camera, but anyway, we're away. You can do better than that. We're coming back. So, the importance of the setup. Clearly, we can see there Keith was aiming off to the right a little bit. So, we're going to just lay down a couple of rods here. Bring these up at the target. Square these up. And then another one just off to the side there. Righto. So, Keith, come on in. So we can see now we're going to try and square Keith up here and get his ball position right in his posture. So some of the things that we need to look at. First of all is alignment, is lining up with toes. It's very common to see a lot of our club golfers not be able to line up square to the target. So Keith, you look down there, you've just got to get your toes square to the target line. Much better. Shoulders are square to the target line and so forth. This is going to help with being able to deliver the club into the ball on the right path. Now, club down on the ground for me, Keith. Next one is posture. So the effects on posture can cause shots left and right. And the best example is when a player gets too steep in their posture and the club starts to sit on the toe, straight away you'll notice that the club face will actually start to point off to the right. So we need to ensure that we've got good posture, the butt sticking out backwards, hands under the chin, club sitting flat on the ground. The next part of the setup is the grip. We've got to really make sure that we're gripping the club correctly. If you haven't got the grip right, this again is going to cause bias either left or right. So there's a few key things to look at, Keith, when we get you out on the course next. Yeah.